In the shadows of the grand PrusaSlicer 2.6 release, Ultimaker has quietly unveiled Ultimaker Cura 5.4 to the public. Yeah, that's right, hot off the press. It brings four intriguing new features, alongside a handful of bug fixes, so let's delve deeper into the four most fascinating ones. Now, this new version may not cause the same explosion of excitement as the PrusaSlicer 2.6 release, which was packed with a plethora of new and updated features. Nonetheless, it's a step in the right direction to keep up with the cutting-edge technology. Beyond the features specifically designed for Ultimaker 3D printer owners, I've discovered four features which can benefit all of us. First up is the hole horizontal expansion max diameter feature. Its purpose is to limit the hole expansion to holes smaller than the specified diameter. This allows you to increase the size of smaller holes if necessary without affecting the larger holes in your 3D print. When I tried enabling it through the setting visibility dialog, I was puzzled. It refused to show up in the sidebar no matter what I did. Finally, I received the missing piece of information. Its visibility depends on setting a value greater than zero in the hole horizontal expansion field. Well, that wasn't very obvious, was it? Here's how it works. Let's say you always struggle with screws fitting through your smaller holes. By setting a value greater than zero in the hole horizontal expansion, you can save the day. However, there's a catch. It will increase the size of every opening in your 3D print, which might not be what you desire. But fear not, because the hole horizontal max diameter feature comes to the rescue. Simply set it to, let's say, 5 mm, and only holes smaller than 5 mm will be affected by horizontal expansion, leaving the rest untouched. These two parts were printed with the same settings, except that the right one has applied the hole horizontal expansion and the hole horizontal max diameter. The M3 screw doesn't fit in the original part, but it fits in the one with hole horizontal expansion. I also printed a row with tolerances applied for M3 screws, so that should fit in both parts. Let's check the same for M4. Barely fits. Here it does. And the same for the M5 screw. Hard to get it in. The part with max horizontal tension just goes through as expected. If you ever experience difficulties removing skirt lines from your build plate because they stick too firmly, you'll absolutely love the new skirt height setting feature. It allows you to print additional skirt lines on top of the first one, making it easier to grab and remove them. Another feature that deserves our appreciation is the smart brim. It tackles a similar, often more frustrating problem, struggling to remove a brim that has fused with a print, requiring tedious cleanup with a knife or deburring tool. By changing the order in which the brim lines are printed, the filament at the seam between the brim and the 3D print gets more time to cool down. As a result, when the adjacent line of the print object is printed, it doesn't fuse with the brim as much as it did with the old approach. Now it's a pure delight to peel off the brim from the finished print with almost no need for deburring. For all the Cura users out there, the wait for tree support is finally over. Although it was included as a preview in 5.3.0 Alpha XMAS, it wasn't officially released until now. With its inclusion in the new release, it's available to everyone. The refined tree support is based on Thomas Rahm's implementation, which already made its way into PrusaSlicer earlier this year. If you want to know more about the motivations behind the development of the improved tree support, I recommend watching what Thomas Rahm, the developer, says about it in the video on Prusa Research's channel, linked in the description. Now, don't blame me for this, but take a look at my print of the Dragon Pencil Holder Cup. It's not one of those flawless prints you often see in other videos, but that's precisely why I decided to showcase it. I suspect the filament's packaging wasn't airtight and it absorbed some humidity. Surprisingly, it seems to have only affected the tree support, which you can see here, while the print itself looks rather nice. One thing worth noting is that Cura's estimated print time was way off compared to the actual printing duration, approximately 9 hours versus around 11 hours. Personally, I find PrusaSlicer's estimations to be far more accurate and honest. What are your thoughts on these new features? Leave your comments down below and don't forget to like and subscribe to support the channel. Thanks a bunch! Happy printing and I'll catch you in the next video!